Why did I do that?
Oh!
Will you focus on me?
Yes, you did. Thank you, camera.
Quite intense. Let's turn some of this down.
Whoop, yeah, throw this hair back one time. Greetings and salutations, everybody. Hey, girl, hey. Today, we're gonna be doing a full face of NYX makeup and a little wear test to go along with it. I have a family party to go to. It's my uncle-in-law's birthday, and every year, there's a big party thrown for him, so that's what we're about to do. We are getting ready together. A little risky, I shall say, depending on how these products go, but we're gonna make it work. We're gonna do our best. Let's get into it. I went to Ulta and I stocked up on some NYX or NYX. I've always said NYX, so that's why I'm gonna say this whole video, but a few people have always said NYX as well. One of the first brands I ever purchased in my, you know, beauty YouTuber life. I used to go to this drugstore near my house and buy the little square single shadows and the square blushes and be able to get like maybe one every couple months, and I always got the weirdest colors. If you guys watched my then and now video, I always got like blues, greens, or yellows. That was just my thing. But we've moved on from that, and we are gonna get into a box full of goodies. I did try to film this other day, wasn't really loving my energy, wasn't really loving how things were going, so I went to go pick up a few other things that I felt like I was missing. At the time of purchase, NYX was buy one, get one 50% off. That is a reoccurring promo that happens at Ulta with, you know, all brands. So if it's not happening right now when you're watching this, you can just wait a little bit, it will come back. One thing about NYX is that they plastic wrap every product individually, woo, which is great for knowing that your products are sanitary in the store, that no one's messed with them, but a pain when it comes to filming. So I've removed just about all of them minus two, so let me do that really quick. Y'all see how long this receipt is? Probably not the longest one you've ever seen for sure, but this is pretty long because I got a bunch of little products. Everything's very affordable though, which is great. To save time, I will put the prices for each product on the screen instead of just saying it out loud. Of course, everything will be linked off down below if you want to use my links and be a real one. I bought a few items from their new Bear With Me collection. I got the new primer, the new skin veil, which is going to be our main bases. I got the cheek products. I did try a couple of these, like I said before, because I did try to film this a few days ago, and I have a few thoughts, which isn't a bad thing. It doesn't have to be a full first impression. And let me know down below what other brands you'd like to see me do full faces of. I probably spent about $150 in total on all the products shown today, which are quite a few products. You probably don't need everything, of course. The first product we're using today is the Jelly Primer. I didn't know what to expect. This is a hydrating primer, but it's really like legit jelly. Like when you touch it, it doesn't come off on your finger. You have to take a chunk, like jello. I was thinking more like sticky, tacky, which is what I'm used to, but this is interesting. So I'm gonna take, oh God. I'm gonna take a good chunk, as you can see, very gelatinous, probably a little too much, but not dripping. And I'm gonna hydrate one side of our face. Get it really in there. This has that like Tatcha Neutrogena water like burst feel to it. So that was definitely more than enough. I probably used half of what I pulled out, but that was more so you guys could really see that texture since it's clear. I was originally thinking this might be a great dupe for the J1 jelly pack that's sold at Sephora, more like an affordable alternative. It's definitely different packaging. One's a pump, this is more liquidy, but the finish is very similar. It is hydrating and sticky to the touch. Bear With Me collection has an 8-hour wear time claim for their products, which is enough for me today. I'm not gonna be out too long, but it is shorter than a lot of things we see nowadays. We see like 10, 12, 24. I'm gonna be using the tinted skin veil in shade beige camel. I did swatch the other shades in the store, and this one seemed to be the most fitting for me and for my twinsies, because the one afterwards, I want to say it was, that was way too dark, and the one before that was definitely even lighter than I would be in the winter time. So this was the best bet. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be forgiving because it's more of a skin veil, but this says that it provides a fresh face look and evens out your skin tone with seamless coverage, breathable, weightless formula, luminous, does not streak, provides 8-hour wear. Squeeze tube moment, and this is not super liquidy, staying in place very, very well. I forgot to wet my sponge. My sponge is wet now, my Morphe and my Velvet. If you see me using a sponge, just assume it's damp. I've gotten a few questions lately. If I am using it dry for some whatever reason, I will most likely make that disclaimer rather than the other way, because I just always use a wet sponge. And I'm gonna be using the Velvet sponge for any additional coverage. Since I did test this the other day, I will tell you that it does streak a little bit, minorly, with a brush, but it does fade into the skin once the skin starts warming up.
I do prefer a sponge, but you can use both. You just have to be a little bit more patient if you're gonna use that brush. It's not like horrible, but it wasn't as pressed in, as flawless, as quick. And you wanna move decently quickly with this product, even though it's not a matte finish. You'll have more lines to deal with if you do not. A little bit does not go a super long way, since I'm already grabbing a little bit more. But that's because I really want, you know, a good amount of something. I don't mind my skin still showing through. It's just, you know, my certain problematic areas. We all have them. I don't want to look too red around the nose, and I don't want to look uneven for sure. I don't believe there's any SPF in this product, and I'll talk more about how many shades there are and all that towards the end of our wear test, since we have a lot of products today. If it was a dedicated foundation review, this is usually when I cover it. It really does sink into the skin very beautifully without hiding, you know, the freckles or the sunspots. That's as even as we are going to get. I did avoid my under eye area, and I will just graze whatever's left on my sponge over my eyelid, since I get very like purpley, you know, vein like. The major problematic areas as far as like darker spots are gonna show, but for the most part redness is concealed naturally. You can still see some tones. You can see my under eye hollow because I keep that area empty for our concealer. And talking about concealer, this is the HD Studio Concealer in shade Sand Beige. I don't know. Let's try it on my face. Let's be honest. Here we go. I tried this so many years ago, I couldn't remember if I liked it or not, but they do favor on the display the Can't Stop, Won't Stop concealer, which I did do a review on. I wasn't in love with it, so I don't have that concealer anymore. I decided to pick this one up instead. So I'm gonna highlight. This smells kind of funny. Almost like tacos a little bit. Flipping my sponge around. I want to assume this is probably more of like a light medium cover concealer compared to the Can't Stop Won't Stop, which is like their full. I don't see why they would have two full coverage liquid concealers in the same packaging. Pat it in place to get the most coverage out of it. First time I filmed this video, I didn't remember to grab this concealer, and it was a whole struggle bus. I was like, oh my god, my under eyes were popping. I'm giving the concealer a moment to settle. And the coverage is starting to kind of look less smooth as it's settling, which means I probably need to lock it in. But I'm gonna be honest, since I'm heading to a family party, I want to cover this and this with a little face colored concealer, because I don't like that showing as much. Everything else, like over here, I'm cool with, but these are very large and will interfere with my contour. And I'm gonna probably add just a dollop of the ColourPop concealer just there. Only under the eyes, because I need a little more assistance, a little bit more correcting, but very minor amounts just in that hollow. For setting powder, I have the Can't Stop Won't Stop loose powder, and when I was filming this originally, that was the first time I've ever used it. It has a stopper, which just tripped me out because I was gonna pour into the lid. I still don't know the proper way to do this. Is it going like this technically? And it's like on the stop or whatever. It's in shade medium, and it has a slight soft focus effect. Kind of gives like a little glowy glow, a little highlight without being too shimmery. I reviewed the foundation, I reviewed the concealer, but this is the powder's time to shine. No pun intended. Shout outs to NYX for the cool stopper, because this actually plugs the holes, and I cannot get the powder out of this crevice now. How do you do this? Mistakes are being made. You guys see, you see the woo. It's a little harder on this eye than this eye, so I might have to even that out a little bit, but wow. NYX Wonder Stick, and this is in shade light. It has the contour and the highlight side. I'm gonna apply a bit to the back of my hand to warm it up, and then try to apply just a little bit on the parts that I would like a little bit more depth. I don't want to break up what we already have going on though. I remember I used to use this when it first came out, and I don't remember how I felt though. I don't think I used it for a very long time, but I don't think I hated it either. It's definitely one of the fan favorites. All right, so that was a good amount of just low-key shape, because we have a powder bronzer to set with, and we also, you know, have this little highlight side, which I might put just in the middle of my nose, which is not straight. Great. I'm gonna try out the Born to Glow Illuminator, and this is in shade Gleam. Never tried this. Pretty. A little bit to the cheekbone, and then Gotta blend it. No, no, but okay. Okay.
It's just getting worse. It's not, might be hitting the edge of the powder. Something. Maybe our powder highlight can save us later. We'll come back to that because that was a little terrifying. It's the hydrating cheek tint from the Bear With Me collection, and this was a beautiful shade. It's called Detox Me, and I could not get this to work for me the first time around. I tried to apply it directly onto my face, and if you can see, there's like a coat of my skin tint on there, which I'm gonna try to get off. But even when I rub it very hard onto my hand, I can't get enough to then transfer it onto my face. But we're gonna try again. Watch out for the chunks though, because some of the chunks will transfer to the face. That happened the first time around too. Now it's all over my legs. The first time around, after I had so many issues with this whole hand technique, I was like, maybe it just has to be applied directly to the face. When I applied it to the face, it took off my face compared to getting onto my face. I'll apply it directly to the bottom of my sponge and just watch out for the chunks. Try to remove the chunks ahead of time. That chunk. Hey, we got color this time though. Wow. Maybe that'll help blend in that little rough highlight we just had. Originally, I bought a bit of jelly highlighter, and I didn't realize that this pretty gold shade actually has a lot of blue and purple reflexes in it. So when you use it, you only get blue and purple reflexes. The gold kind of just blends away, which did not go with the other color schemes of things I was buying. So this is a no for me, but I think this would be great if you are into something for like your body or for like a festival, or if you want something with blue and purple flex. That just ideally wasn't what I was going for. I thought it'd be at least base gold. Putting on some lip balm to prep our lips for it later, because you know your girl ain't the most hydrated girl in the bunch. I think we're gonna redirect, come back to the cheeks later. Let's work on our eyebrows while I just kind of let that blush set for a second. You know, I don't want to move it around too much. NYX released this Fluff and Fill eyebrow pencil, and it has a really unique kind of like oval shape, really soft even brush at the end that's supposed to help fluff your hairs up. So naturally, because of its claims, it's before and after, it says it's an eyebrow pomade pencil, I thought it would have a little bit of a sticky, maybe waxy hold to it. It does not have that. I learned the first time around. This is in shade ash brown, and I wear ash brown in almost all the lines, but this is a very dark ash brown for me. I thought this looked more like chocolate, more deep brown. This was not good when I put it on my eyebrows. It looked a lot darker. So if you're looking for something with more of like a cream to powder finish, because it gets a lot lighter when it sets and you blend it, it just looks more like, you know, eyeshadow lighter finish, you would like this. I might use it maybe at the ends of my brows if I need to, but I went out and bought their best-selling micro brow pencil. Pretty standard as far as packaging goes. This is in shade chocolate, which is the shade before ash brown, kind of different, but a little warmer. So I figured maybe this would give me what I was originally looking for. And I'm gonna touch up the areas I usually do. When they say micro, it really is. It does very nice small hair-like strokes, very easy. You don't have to put a lot of pressure on it. Ooh, I love it. For eyes, we're just gonna do liner and lashes. I picked up these really cute, really luxe packaging, forewarning, Blinking Beauty. Blinking Beauty, yeah, or Butte. I don't know how they actually pronounce it, but I'm gonna say Beauty, Blinking Beauty lashes that come in this acrylic box. Only certain Ultas have this, but this is put in the Ultas that also have, I think, Velour, House of Lashes, and Lily Lashes, so they're all in the same display. And this was the only brand that I didn't try out of that display, so I was like, okay, let me give you guys a shot. Very, very luxe acrylic box. You could probably reuse this to store your jewelry or, you know, lip balms, whatever you want to put in there, earrings. You just take the lashes out. These are in Style Brill. I'm gonna use these, and I have the NYX Matte Liquid Liner. When I originally did this video, I had a Wang, a really nice sharp Wang liner. I don't think I'm gonna go as dramatic today. I wanna go a little bit more subtle for the family party, but this was easily achieved with this liner. So if you need something that gives you a nice clean matte wing, this is great. It's only $7, I believe. I do have a problem with it on my inner corner though. Certain lashes don't stick on my inner corner, and probably within an hour, my inner corner was completely bare. It didn't look horrible. It didn't look messy. It didn't melt, but it was bare. So I'm gonna lay down a liquid liner that will probably stick a little better just in that inner corner before I put this on top, because if I do it the other way around, then most of it will be matte and then that area will be shiny and we don't want that. I use the M Cosmetics eyeliner for that because it does stick pretty well on those corners. Crossing our fingers we don't end up with a wang again. It has a super fine brush tip, very flexy though, so be careful. I'm doing my liquid liner with a brush tip that's like this, very flexible, and it takes maybe like 10 seconds to dry. I do like to work back and forth from my eye, so I give, you know, one side its time to set before it like goes up my lid by accident. I try to keep my eyes looking down as well. That's why I'm not making as much eye contact. Looking down also gives you the best chance at having a thinner line because you're, you know, keeping your eyelids pretty flat. Part of me knows I should stop right here. Part of me wants the tiniest little flick at the end. So baby wings, this one got a little thicker, but it's okay, we're not gonna stress it. We can breathe now. I'm gonna stick my lashes on. These lashes are super light, super comfortable. Very surprised. They are in the same price range as the other brands I listed. These are, I think, $26, but are reusable. I can't speak for other styles being super comfy either. I mean, this is the only style I've tried, but these are nice. Amazing. Ooh, look at the difference. Okay, why did I do that? And take the smallest angle brush I own by Valair and take a little bit of liquid liner and try to fix this little spot that I hit with my lash. Liner and lashes above are done. We're gonna do a little lower lash line. Nude colored eyeliner. It's called the Always Keeping It Tight liner, so obviously good for the waterline, a retractable one. I did notice that this one does break pretty easily, so you have to keep the pressure light. And depending on if I put mascara on before or after this, I sometimes have to touch it up, but like so, as you can see, it's definitely brighter. I'm gonna throw some mascara onto the lower lashes. I've been testing out the new Too Faced mascara. Don't know how I feel about it yet, honestly. It does flake a little bit, so keep that in mind. It definitely gives you a good effect though. Like, hello, who has lashes now? It gets so messy. Like, when you try to wipe off the brush, it just stays on the top because of its texture. Oh! I hit myself in the hand and then I jerked my hand away from the mascara and hit myself in the face. Oh yes, right before we were done. Of course we did. Tip is to use the most small amount of makeup remover on a very fluffy but focused brush, or you can use a Q-tip. It just depends on where I hit that I decide to use a brush or a Q-tip to be a little bit more precise compared to having a circle on my face, but I think we saved that pretty well. Before we hit our lips, we're gonna try this California Beaming bronzer. This is in shade The Golden One. Kind of a shimmery, satiny finish, so if you don't like that, you might not like this. You can see the reflective nature of it. So I'm gonna try to not use too much before I look like a fake bronzed version. Quite a bit right there. A little translucent powder. Kind of tone down what we got going on. I don't want to look like a clown. I'm gonna add a little highlight. This is a new one by Koki. I used it the first time I filmed this video and I loved how it came out. It's really nice and wet looking. So yes, this is not a NYX product, but it helps the look balance out a little bit. You can already see what the NYX products look like. And that liquid highlighter didn't save us earlier, so. And last but not least, I have two of the Powder Puff lipsticks. One is more of a mauve-y pink color, which is Best Buds. Very pretty. And then there's also Teacher's Pet, which I feel like goes really well with the blush we have going on right now. So it has a kind of cotton puff, Q-tippy doe foot going on, that shape. And then you just squeeze it and apply, and it feels like nothing. I love it. I love it so much. It looks so flattering even on my busted and crusted lips. These just claim to be lightweight, moussey, and set to a powdery soft finish. Definitely gives us those popsicle summer vibes. So we're gonna finish off our face with some setting spray. This is the Dewy Finish NYX setting spray. I'm gonna do some prep pumps. Okay, this is a little bit of a harsher hit, so we're gonna stretch as far as we can. Pretty. I think that's about it, guys. I might put just a little bit of this highlighter on my brow bone, center of the lid. Maybe we'll see how I feel. I think I kind of like it without. Maybe just brow bone after this set. I gotta get going to the party, can't be late. So I will see you guys at the end of the day and we will talk about what we got left. 10:40 at night and I had a long day at the family party. But great food, great times. I'm exhausted and my lip color is all gone. As you can see, I kind of got just a little outline left of the Powder Puff Lippy. So I'm going to reapply that for just, you know, presentation sake. Actually, why don't we try out the other color? This is Best Buds. One of my eyelashes are starting to come off. It's been rough. That's just real talk. It is strange that this color has like way more of a moussey texture compared to Teacher's Pet, which has more of like the straight up powder finish almost out the gate, because it's supposed to be mousse to powder. But this one's way creamier, not exactly a shade I'd rock. I don't think it goes well with my skin tone, so we're gonna abort. But at least you guys got to see what Best Buds look like. It looks way more mauve-y on the display in Ulta because they have like a model wearing the shade specifically. It don't look mauve-y on me, it look baby pink. Here we are, I look pretty rough, especially this eye. Can you see that little stain? Whoa, eyeliner transfer. This eye, it's all the way down here. I'm just having a moment, it seems. Let's throw some pictures up on the screen. Definitely been over 8 hours. It's closer to 9 right now, so we're really gonna see what's going on. Quick overview of my face. My blush is definitely still there. My skin is still even. Lip color, obviously, we've already reported in. Brows are looking flaky still. Liner, not too bad, but we have certain spots where it could be just a little better. So I'm gonna go through and go in order. The Bare With Me Hydrating Jelly Primer, I think, is an awesome win. I do wish it wasn't a pot, a pump, something else. Just not my favorite packaging, I'm sure. Very big for travel and generally kind of hard to scoop out because of the texture being so jello-like compared to even a sticky jelly. It kind of wants to adhere to itself within the jar. But overall, it did seem like it helped a little bit. I think there's more redness showing on this side of my nose than the prime side. And I also feel like the coverage held a little better on this side than the other. So I think it did work at least decently well. My skin did look very hydrated and moisturized. That little extra oomph was great. This gets my stamp of approval. Moving on to the Tinted Skin Veil. This is actually pretty awesome. I'm not very greasy at all right now. Actually, not really at all. My nose is starting to look, you know, highlighty, but it doesn't feel bad. It doesn't feel greasy. It doesn't feel tacky. My skin is overall a great color for my body, and it is nice and smooth on the forehead area, anywhere I don't have texture, and it's not horrible in my texture areas either. I think it does look better when you don't powder it, but it's not gonna last as long. I think it did hold up well for the 8 hours, and even then, so a little bit more. I was running around. I'm very, very like active at the family party as far as like cleaning this, washing that, running around, serving this, da da da. That's just how I am. So it hanged on. I looked pretty smooth and good, and it's very lightweight, which is great. These are the 6 colors that this comes in. I have the 3rd shade. As you can see, the other shades after are definitely more for tan, deep, and possibly darker. I can't vouch for how dark that shade may go, but I definitely feel like I have that medium, because there's like a fair, a light medium, medium, tan, deep. There's one for every category, it seems. But it's not a bad medium. It definitely has that yellow golden. Brow pencils. So the Micro Brow, I gave it all of its praise. Looks great. The Fluff and Feel, I told you kind of my problems with it. Don't feel like this would work for my brows, that naturally some of them grow down. So to fluff it and fill it, I do like that like fluffy look. So if it worked, I would love it, but it doesn't have enough texture to it to actually do what it needs to. Plus, this brush honestly is not gonna do much. It's a very soft, even brush. It doesn't have much taper to it. It kind of is like running like a flat foundation brush, but smaller on your eye. It is more of a triangular shape, so it is harder to get those like fine inner corner strokes. I had a hard time when I first used it. I'm gonna approve that, but I do approve the other brow pencil. Told you guys about the jelly already, so we don't have to get too much into that. I think the Waterline Always Keeping It Tight liner, it lasted pretty well, probably more on this side than this side. I don't know what happened to this guy over here, but you can still see the brightness there, and it's nice, fine, micro, small. I'm definitely gonna use it again. The liquid highlighter in Gleam, I think I will give it another shot another time, but I did not like how quickly it just, it wasn't going to be any more forgiving on me. It does have more of a boom though. It did act as a base over here for my
additional highlight. I think it shines better on this side. I don't find this the most forgiving formula. So if you already have trouble with, you know, liquid highlighters, glow products and such, and you don't want to fuss with it, then maybe pass on this. It's not a bad color. It's beautiful, but it's not the easiest to work with. Liquid liner, this is their matte. If 10 out of 10 was a liner that just doesn't budge, I'd give this a solid 8. If it does budge, it's gonna come off kinda rough, if you know what I mean, a little chunky sometimes, because it will come off maybe in a square patch or something. So that makes it almost a little problematic, but the formula itself is a beautiful opaque black matte that is just crisp, statement, lovely, affordable. The Wonder Stick in light is one of the most Instagrammable products you see all the time. People love contouring their face with it. I don't find it as creamy as I wish it was. It's a little less creamy than the Kim Kardashian contour sticks, but it's way more affordable. So if you're looking for something like this, it isn't bad. I only went out of order because I don't remember what products I put in what order now, but the HD concealer wasn't great. It was great at first. It like impressed me, had a great first impression, but I think throughout the day it started to wear down more and more, and it's sitting very funny. You see those lines? See the wrinklage? It's like creating a weird L in wrinkles, which doesn't happen too much. It's definitely showing those like movement marks, tugging at the skin, not sitting how I'd want it to. I want something that moves with the skin a little bit more than this. So I won't give the concealer my stamp of approval, but this Can't Stop, Won't Stop powder does get my approval. It has that more soft focus effect. I like the packaging, minus the fact that I have no clue where to put the powder when I take the powder out. It is a good shade. Shade medium for me and my twinsies. What we got left? What we got left? Oh, the Bear With Me Tinted Cheek. Our blush, our booming blush that lasted all day. The Detox Me Hydrating Cheek Tint. It definitely gives you a flush, a stain, and you do have to figure out how to make it work for you as far as application goes. But it's not a bad shade for summer. I think the lip really helped coordinate together. It is very pigmented if you can get it onto your face. Not a bad cheek blush, not the easiest to work with. I'll give it a solid B. The California Beaming Bronzer in Golden One is definitely golden. Way more golden than I expected. I still have a reflex like in this one spot where I first like touched down with it. If you like bronzers that literally make you glow as well, you'll probably like this big guy, but this is not my type of taste. This isn't actually what most of my bronzers look like in the pan too, so I was kind of confused. I think this comes in 3 shades total, and I was like, none of them really look like my ideal tones I usually gravitate towards, but this was what it was intended for being this big. But it does say bronzer, and NYX surprisingly has, yes, like a contour palette, but not a lot of solo bronzers, like 2 shades, 3 shades, and that's kind of surprising. Last but not least is the Dewy Finish Setting Spray. This worked pretty well. I don't think it gives as fine of a finish as Fix Plus does, or even the Morphe spray. It's just okay, but it didn't really give me a dewy finish. I still look pretty darn matte. I checked my face right after I hopped in the car and I was like, I'm pretty darn matte. I'm really matte right now. Generally, I don't think I look dewy at all. So take that as you will. Top 3 picks: powder, primer, base. Side note shout out, the Blinking Beauty Lashes, very comfortable, very nice. Not lifting because of its quality, lifting because I've been through things. Ooh, let's take them off together, shall we? Thank you guys, as always, for watching and hopefully enjoying this video. All the links will be down below for all the products shown in today's video. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe because we like new members who want to stick around. If you're going to watch some more videos anyway, you might as well. And let me just help you out by putting my latest uploads right on right here. Also, getting off this liquid liner is not the funnest thing to do. It really takes some diligence. And that is all for me today. Don't forget to comment down below what other brands you would like me to do videos like this on. And I will see you guys in a later video. Ring ring, what's that? My shower.